And the reason why you want to build your own DMP or why people are moving in that direction is there's this need to be able to understand and aggregate data from a lot of different places. We're getting data from our first party publishing partners, we're getting data from third parties, we're using data from our client CRM databases. And in order to really architect and put together the appropriate data strategy, you need a place to warehouse all of that. Now, I also believe it has to be an open architecture because we certainly have clients that are building their own DMPs as well. So you have to have the flexibility to be able to pull in the right data, massage that data, and utilize it to really drive the best results for your clients' needs. I think it's going to fuel two things. Programmatic buying for sure will be a big part of that. I think we're also very focused on automation of process and workflow. And so when we talk a lot about where we think the future is going, it's more about just using technology and data to support all of our buying, whether that be a direct button sponsorship through something our agencies are doing directly with a client, or that's through a programmatic channel. So I think the use of data and technology and things like DMPs will absolutely fuel the future of how we do our media buying, whether it's, again, direct to that publisher or whether it's through a programmatic channel. There's still fragmentation within the brands when they start to look across different channels, and I think that's the first challenge is today you have radio buyers that are specific for radio, you have teams that are specific to digital, you have teams that are specific to television. And I think what we're starting to see is this convergence of how do you start to measure reach and frequency to the appropriate audiences across those channels. So I think that's the first challenge, is how do they break down those barriers internally as a client to be able to actually have a conversation that goes across screen, because typically their budgets are allocated based on that individual channel. So I think as that converges, you start to have a more holistic view of how you're actually reaching your core audiences and what the optimal frequency is at which you should be reaching those audiences. So I think that's the first challenge. I think other challenges are people are still learning how to use their data today and how that could best actually help drive their business. So I think as again, DMPs continue to evolve and as people start to understand the benefits of them, they'll start to better use data and actually going out and targeting those appropriate audiences. We're still teaching clients today how to onboard their CRM data and how to utilize it as an effective tactic for buying as well. So I think those are the areas they're going to focus on to go forward. People are starting to use different tactics to be able to figure out how to better drive efficiency within their business. I think the modeling now and the ability to use technology and data has gone so far that you can actually start to build real strategies around everything from when you're simply making a consumer aware of a brand message all the way down to when they're actually purchasing your product or your offering. So I think you're now able to apply data to the full consumer lifecycle of your engagement with the consumer. And it's providing people with really strategic and interesting opportunities to think smarter and more strategic about how they do their media buying as they go forward.